Hello, my name is Camille Lassalle. I'm a postdoctoral researcher at Imperial College London in the School of Public Health in the Department of Epidemiology and Biostatistics. Here at the American Heart Association EPI and Lifestyle Session 2015, I'm presenting results on a pro-vegetarian dietary pattern and its association with cardiovascular mortality. And our population of study are participants to the EPIC study, which is a pan-European study that includes 10 European countries. And we have 450,000 participants in this study. So we have their dietary intake at baseline, and they were followed up for approximately 12 years. And so we assessed their adherence to a pro-vegetarian diet, and the way we define a pro-vegetarian diet is we counted positively 7 plant-based food groups: fruit, vegetables, grains, legumes, potatoes, nuts, and vegetable oils. And on the other hand, the animal-based food groups intake were counted negatively, and this was meat, all meat included poultry, fish, eggs, dairy, and animal fats. So we had then an entire score with the lowest score, meaning a lowest adherence to a pro-vegetarian diet, and a highest score, higher adherence. So in the lower category, participants consumed approximately 45% of their diet coming from plant food, whereas in the high and very high categories, it was between 70 and 80% of their intake that were coming from plant sources. And what we observed is that in these categories, in the high or very high adherence to a pro-vegetarian diet, people had a 20% risk reduction to die of cardiovascular disease compared to the low adherence to a pro-vegetarian diet. So the very simple message is that it's a gradual and realistic change from animal to plant-based food, and substituting some of the meat intake by plant-based foods such as legumes or grains can be an efficient way, and realistic and simple way, to reduce cardiovascular risk.